Well, thanks to Jacob Peranna's game-winning goal in his Red Wings debut, Detroit has now won three straight games for the very first time this year. Now they'll close out their season series against the Chicago Blackhawks, hoping to stretch that to four straight and put a crimp in Chicago's playoff hopes at the same time. How cool would that be if you're a Red Wings fan? Hello, everybody, and welcome to this edition of Red Wings Live here on Bally Sports. I'm Trevor Thompson, joined by the four-time Stanley Cup champion and Hockey Hall of Famer, Larry Murphy. He's to my right tonight. And Murph, on Thursday, Red Wing fans got everything they wanted. They got a third straight win for the first time this year. They got to put a crimp in Chicago's playoff hopes. That was pretty cool. And Jacob Varana got a goal in his very first game as a Red Wing. What are your expectations here tonight, my friend?
Why not the same, Trev? Why not the same? And for the Wings, that's exactly what they're going to try to do. The same game plan. We saw a lot of areas where they were strong. And the penalty kill, that's got to do it. They've got to do it. Keep that Hawk, powerful Hawk, power play off the board. They've also got to keep that sustained offensive pressure. They carried the play to the Hawks last game. This wasn't a situation where the Hawks took the Wings too lightly. It was a case of the Wings outplaying Chicago. We want to see the same thing again tonight.
Now, at the trade deadline, you were the first to say that Troy Stecher would be the guy who benefits most from the trading of Patrick Nemeth and John Merrill. Then he goes out and has his first multi-goal game as an NHLer, making you look like a genius in the process. What is it you like about his game? How was he effective Thursday? Break it down for us in tonight's GMC Pro Vision.
Trev, I did not see the two-goal game coming from him, but I did see the opportunity that was presenting itself to him. More ice time, more responsibility, and he has taken advantage of it. This play here, it started actually in the wing zone, deep on the goal line. That's where Stecher had the puck initially. Moves up along the boards. Sees that he's got available ice time. Yeah, it's not the greatest goal in hockey, but still, if you fire it on the net, you get as close as you can. He does exactly that. Lankinen bobbles the puck. In the net it goes. That's the first one. This one, too. The second goal. Another case of Stecher. The play did start behind this goal line, and he moved up in the play to Kaiser. Just a tremendous pass. Stecher, presence of mind. He was actually behind the goal line, brought it back on his backhand, tapped it in the net. Two great goals by a guy, Trip, that plays hard. This is a guy that plays with a lot of energy, a lot of jump. Moves up in the play quickly. He's not the biggest guy out there, but you're not going to outwork him. That's where his success comes from. He's seeing more ice time now, as you touched on. Merrill and Nemeth have moved on. This is a guy, yeah, we're going to see Lindstrom or Biega or Chalowski see some ice time now. But Stecher is going to see his minutes grow, and he's a smart veteran guy, and he's going to try to take advantage of it, and he's done it so far.
And Murph, another guy you mentioned right there, Gustav Lindstrom. He picked up an assist the other night. This is his third game here tonight of the season, but he's playing with a lot of confidence, and he says a lot of that came in the offseason with the work he put in, because as that old saying goes, Murph, if you can't skate, you can't play. And that's what he focused on in the offseason, and that's tonight's Coors Light Report. Well, what he went on there to say, Murph, was that he really worked hard on his skating because it affects every aspect of the game. What are you seeing out there, and how does he fit in with the new kids?
Well, he played last season. He played, what, how many games? 16 games last year, and he looked very strong on the blue line. This year, with the new players coming in, kind of pushed him down on the chart. He didn't see any games early on the season. Played in Sweden, went to Grand Rapids. But what we saw from him last year, and we've seen it from him so far this year, is his poise, his presence out there, positioning is excellent. And on that goal by Varana, he made a tremendous play, knowing he's coming out of the box, and threw it up to him for the breakaway. He's a guy that plays with a lot of smarts. He's adding to his repertoire more strength, more foot speed. But he's got that basic knowledge, that head for hockey, and that's why I think this guy is going to be very successful for the Wings, long time coming. He's got some ground to cover in terms of his quality of play, but still, I haven't seen anything right now that doesn't convince me that this guy is going to be a regular Red Wing one day.
Yeah, and that was our Xfinity look around the league, and there you see Gustav Lindstrom getting set to play in his third game as a Red Wing, and certainly his future is bright. And down in Ann Arbor, there are a lot of Wolverines who have very bright futures as well. A handful of these guys could go in the top 10 in this year's upcoming NHL draft. Owen Power, he's a man-child, a hulking defenseman on the blue line for the Wolverines, and he could go as high as number one overall. And he says he's doing that with a little help from his friends.
It's awesome to see. We got a great group of guys, super talented group. So it's tons of fun. And then I think just being able to kind of see them and pick stuff from their game every day and work with them to try and get better is really helpful and a lot of fun.
Murph, this guy says that he wants to model his game after Victor Hedman. Yeah, that's a former Norris Trophy winner right there, a guy with a pretty good set of skills. Certainly, we all know that. What are you seeing in his game, and what similarities at this stage do you see between him and a Victor Hedman?
Well, I guess the obvious answer, Trev, is the height. I mean, 6'5". What, Hedman's 6'6"? But Owen Power is a guy that, as you touched on, could be as high as first, might slip to fourth. Unfortunately for him, the University of Michigan was pulled out of the NCAA championship tournament because of COVID issues, so he never really got to solidify his position. He's a guy that sees the ice great, can skate through players, as you see here, makes real smart passes. He played against, he was a freshman, but played against the best players in college hockey. The coach was not shy to put him out there. A real heads up. He's got some offensive punch to his game. Tremendous shot. Skates very well. This is somebody, Trev, that could possibly play as an 18-year-old in the National Hockey League next season. But I don't want to put that pressure on him and maybe Norris Trophy down the road, but this guy was outstanding season. He's going to definitely be a high pick. And then the wings, you know, the wings are looking very closely. Be interesting to see if he's available. Well, if Detroit, you never have enough defensemen.
He would fit in.